I was like Andy in my family, which, so Andy is like the guy that he's always singing and everybody's like, even when you're watching the show, you're like, this guy's annoying. And so that's how I treated music. And I never really thought anybody would want to listen to my music.
Découvre en exclusivité tous tes artistes d'ici en t'abonnant maintenant à la chaîne du Warm Up.
Ce matin, on est avec un artiste extrêmement talentueux que je connais très bien, the one and only John. How you doing, John?
Hey, merci beaucoup pour me recevoir ici. Mon nom est John, Jonathan. Yeah. Et franchement, je dois dire, c'est vraiment un privilège de me trouver ici ce matin. C'est vraiment une opportunité que j'aurais jamais imaginé, ou même de être dans ce lieu ici. Ça fait même pas 5 mois que je suis en train de faire la musique.
That's
alors,
crazy.
C'est fou de me retrouver ici. Puis ouais, je suis vraiment content de d'être ici avec toi, Anthony.
Anytime, yeah. Anytime. It's your place today. Aujourd'hui, on va apprendre à découvrir. You're gonna perform for us. Parce que tu sais, tu chantes en français, tu chantes en anglais. You're Italian.
Yeah.
So we need to talk about it.
Yeah.
And you officially passed 1 million.
Yeah.
Stream on Spotify. That's insane. Yeah. In like 5 months. That's crazy, bro. Congratulations.
Thanks,
for
man.
It. First of all.
Honestly, it's something I would have never really imagined for myself. You know, a lot of these songs, they were written throughout the course of a year where I was really, it was a difficult time in my life. And, you know, I just wrote these songs more for myself, never really thinking anybody would ever listen to them. And so to be here 5 months later, really, for like I say, by the grace of God, to be in a place where there's a million streams, it's insane. Like I would have never, I was telling you right before, to have a song that says I miss the days back at Dawson, which is a reference that so few people would actually understand that because we're from Montreal. But when I wrote it, it just made sense to me. And to think that now, like, there's almost 500,000 people that listen to that song specifically, it's insane, really.
How do you feel?
Crazy, like, it's surreal. Je vais dire en français aussi. Franchement, j'aurais jamais imaginé me trouver dans un place ici, puis d'avoir ce qui m'est passé. Franchement, c'est fou.
It's crazy aussi parce qu'on salue aussi que t'es accompagné de ce matin avec, je pense que ton guitariste, Working Together. Puis là, c'était un son de guitare parce qu'on est en live. On like that. Ce matin, il y a trop d'énergie en studio. John, for real. How did like everything start? Like, pourquoi t'as décidé justement de t'aventurer dans la musique?
Yeah, so j'aime ça. On passe de le français à l'anglais. C'est vraiment. But look, so I grew up playing music in church.
Yeah.
So my parents are pastors in Montreal. My dad was a pastor in Montreal North in Saint Michel. So you know, we grew up in a normal house. And ils m'ont toujours poussé vraiment de jouer le piano. Puis c'était pas vraiment quelque chose que j'aimais plus que ça. Puis déjà, quand j'étais jeune, je suis le type de personnage où vraiment c'est difficile de me forcer à faire quelque chose que je suis pas vraiment convaincu personnellement à faire, tu vois. Mais il voulait vraiment que je joue le piano. I wasn't down, and my dad would try to bribe me by giving me ice cream after every piano lesson. It just wasn't working. And then one day, this lady in my church, she heard that I was, you know, that I wanted to play guitar, and she looked at me and she's like, John, she's like, if you promise me that you'll learn how to play guitar and sing in church, then I'll buy you a guitar. And so I was like, okay, like I was like 12 years old, you know, so I was just like, okay, free guitar, like, let's do this. Of course, I'll play anywhere. Like, I'll play at a bar if you want me to play. And that, I'm joking. So that's exactly what happened. And I ended up playing guitar growing up in church. And that was really my only experience with music. It was just strictly related to church. And then in 2018, I went through a really, like, c'était vraiment une période difficile. Genre, 2018, c'était pour beaucoup ceux qui... 2020, pour plusieurs.
Ouais. En ce moment, yeah.
So, and...
What happened? Why?
Yeah, just a lot of personal things in my life that happened and really culminated. And I think that when you're not taking care of yourself, when you're not, you know, focusing on things in your own life that are causing you to slow down and regress, it does end up catching up to you. And so it was like a big stop. And for me, the way that I was processing that was really just to write music. And it wasn't something that I ever thought that, like, I don't know if you watched The Office.
Yeah.
But this is the way I treated my music and my voice. Uh-huh. I was like Andy in my family, so Andy is like the guy that he's always singing, and everybody's like, even when you're watching the show, you're like, this guy's annoying. And so that's how I treated music. And I never really thought anybody would want to listen to my music. Like, genuinely, I'm not trying to be humble. I'm like, nobody cares. Like, and so, but in 2018, I was just writing and writing and writing. And so obviously I went through a relational, like, breakup, I guess. And you know, when you go through a breakup in your 20s, it's kind of weird because I've only ever been in one relationship, I guess. And so it's like, you know, for me, I knew that I didn't want to do what a lot of guys or a lot of people my age do, which is, you know, you go through a breakup and it's just like, I'm going to start dating people. And it was just like, for me, like, for a year and a half, I didn't go out, I didn't see anybody, I didn't text anybody. I just really focused on me and really was like, what is God trying to teach me in this season of my life? What do I need to learn about myself? And a lot of that just happened through music. And so I started a company, and I was just working at the company. I was doing music on the side. And actually Brian introduced me to my producer, Kevin Figgs. So massive shout out to Kevin Figgs. Love that guy. He's like my brother to me. But I was doing a shoot for a guitar company, Godin, which sponsored my guitars today. So full circle. Wow. Nice. But anyway, so we did this shoot, and Brian tells Kevin, oh, by the way, John like writes songs, he does music. And it was so random because Brian had no idea that I was writing for a year and a half from 2018 to 2019. Brian tells Kevin, like, oh, John plays songs, or he writes his own songs. So Kevin is a producer. He was like, oh, come by the studio. Now, just to give you a bit of context, Kevin's worked with Bulow, he's worked with Jeremy, he's worked with Danny Lay. This is a massive, probably one of the most, for me, the most talented producer in Montreal. And so he's like, come by the studio. And I was like, ah, bro, like, not, I'm not really down. And like, but he really insisted. And so I was in his studio. We passed by after the shoot, and there's two talented musicians. Brian is an amazing musician, much better than I am. And he's making faces. It's true. And so Kevin's like, play something. So I just played something that I wrote. And it was like dead silent after I played, and nobody had heard this song before. And Kevin just looks at me. He's like, are you working with anybody? And I'm like, no, not really. And he's like, I'll produce your EP. And I told him, like, well, is it okay if we don't release it though? Like, just for myself, like, I don't really want to release this music. And just to say that je veux pas trop y long.
No, that's a great story. But that's a great story, bro. C'est important de partager. Yeah. You know, when you start, yeah, tout a commencé. Mais ça, yeah, ça, je voulais poser la question justement. Tu parlais de le monde qui, yeah, qui sont talentueux autour de toi. It's good, yeah, to be part 100%. Of the team, you know, right?
So
like, who inspired you? Tu sais, comme qui, mm-hmm, qui t'a influencé côté musical, your, yeah, style? Parle-nous un peu de ça, tes inspirations.
Yeah, I mean, I try to be as me as possible. But uh-huh, for me, like I said, I grew up in church. So a big part of my influence was like Joel Houston, Hillsong United, contemporary worship. And it really influenced the way I write, uh-huh, my own music. But then obviously, like, I'm obsessed with people like for me, Justin Bieber, the prince of pop, like, and I don't know, I'm just saying, like, for our generation, I think he's,
yeah,
I love Justin Bieber and John Mayer, Ed Sheeran, those guys really really influenced
good
me. But just to bring it full circle, so, you know, just a few weeks later, I work on this EP with Kevin. We're making this music, and we end up releasing it. And 3 days before the release, I had like an anxiety attack at 3 o'clock in the morning. I'm like, I can't believe I'm gonna release this. And the thing is, they're so personal. Like, every song was written by, like, I wrote it by myself, not because I want to write it by myself, but just because, you know, it's my own experiences, and nobody could tell my own experiences the way I can. And I was like, imagine, like, 100 people listen to these songs, and only they
and
all know the exact,
now a million,
yeah, but they know all the exact details. And so after a month, it was like, I was getting hit up by like I don't know if I'm allowed to say this, but like by major league, by a major,
insane,
by management. And I was like, is this a scam? So I was Googling everybody that was reaching out to me. And yeah, and it just became full circle.
Be proud, my friend. Be proud. Thank you, man. Be proud.
That.
For real. I'm so happy for you. You're so talented. And this morning, you're going to perform for us one of your songs.
Yeah.
Because yesterday I was listening to all your album and it's amazing. It's a good vibe. I like it. For real.
Thank you.
And we're going to keep pushing. We're going to keep putting on the station. Yeah. So I'm super excited. Yeah. Super excited for you.
Thank you.
And I know you're working on a lot of things, albums. So do you listen to like artists from Montreal?
Of course.
I want to know.
Of course. Okay. I'm going to answer this question, but I think it's really important to say that nobody champions Montreal music the way you do. Really. And je voulais dire tantôt, puis je vais le dire en français parce que c'est vraiment important que je le dise. Mais franchement, je suis fier de toi. Je sais que c'est pas facile du tout de faire ce que tu es en train de faire, mais je vois vraiment que tu as un talent pour unir les personnes, puis ça prend quelqu'un vraiment particulier de faire ce que tu es en train de faire, de créer. Je sais que j'avais publié sur Instagram l'autre journée que en 2017, en fait, c'était même pas 2018.
Yeah.
Je pense que c'était une période où même le warm-up, c'était un peu chaud. Puis je me rappelle ce que tu m'avais dit. Tu m'avais dit, Joe, je veux créer quelque chose. Puis je veux que les personnes mangent avec moi. Puis c'est pas vraiment l'expression que j'avais jamais entendue avant. Puis Montréal, ça, je pense qu'on a la tendance de penser tout le monde soi-même.
Exactly.
Mais franchement, je suis vraiment fier de toi pour le parcours que tu es en train de faire.
Thank you, bro.
Pour les artistes montréalais, man, this is tricky because I'm gonna I'll drop three names that I'm obsessed with.
Because I'm thinking about collaboration. And you know, a lot of people pass by the warm-up, and
I'm like,
I have a lot of names for you.
Yeah, like, I'm obsessed with three Montreal artists right now. One of them is for sure, like, Charlotte Cardin. Like, what an amazing
Charlotte,
artist.
She's
love,
amazing. She's
love
amazing.
What she does. But even Alicia Moffett, amazing.
Yeah, yeah.
And, you know, you put me onto a few artists because I'm a fan of the show before anything. And so even people like Fred's. Wow.
Yeah.
Crazy.
Yeah, he's amazing.
JT Soul. Like, these are people that I literally just discovered watching the show. And so there's so many talented people. But, you know, for the first two that I mentioned, the first three, like, I love writing songs. And so I have, like, songs with stems. I'm like, man, if ever I had the opportunity to work with this person, I would send them this song. And so, but yeah, I definitely love Montreal music. And thank you for showing and showcasing. So even Claudia Bouvet.
Yeah.
Crazy.
Yes,
these are all people I learned through watching the show. So
that's your style. I know that's your style. Yeah. I like that.
Yeah,
like
that. For sure. The indie pop.
Drop names. I'm like, yo, that's your style.
Yeah.
That's
so if any of these,
John,
if any of these people reach out, it's because I have songs for you already that I'll send you the stems, just lay vocals on them.
That's
and,
it. No, 100%. That's why we're here. It's all about collaboration in Montreal. Tu comprends?
Yeah.
Mais si je te dis ton téléphone en ce moment, if you open your phone, what is the three songs that like you always listening to?
Right now, okay, I would say so. Going
tell
in here,
my
bro,
song, yeah, tell me.
Je suis en pleine louange, like Jesus, help me with this interview. Alors, I was listening to a song, but any other situation, je pense, je suis en train d'écouter Lainey. I love Lainey.
Oh,
I love
nice.
The 1975.
Yeah.
But I mean, for me, like people that really influenced me are people like Ed Sheeran. Like, I love Ed Sheeran, and I think it's because he literally crafted the soundtrack for a generation of people in relationships. Like, if you're in your 20s, like an Ed Sheeran song most likely was the song for you. Like, I went to so many weddings, and bro, okay, this is shout out to Anthony Dagger, number one wedding host in the world. But how many times have you had to play Thinking Out Loud for weddings?
Yeah.
And if it's not Thinking Out Loud, it's perfect.
Mm-hmm.
And so for me, someone like Ed Sheeran really inspires me, because to be able to create music that people build life moments, that build connections with, like, that would be my dream. And so that's why I've been so blessed. Like, when I really realized the music was getting real for me, was I was getting messages and I was showing my parents. I'm like, oh, this person sent me this message saying they love this song, they love these lyrics. And that was happening like on a daily basis, to the point that like almost every single day I'm getting new messages of people saying like, hey, thank you for releasing I Hurt You, I Don't Deserve You, because it related, or I loved you since college. And you're like, how does a song that speaks about Dawson College relate with someone from Sydney, Australia? Like, it's surreal. And yet and yet it does. And so to be able to create lyrics that shape moments and memories for people, that's really like a dream of mine. And that's why definitely he's someone that inspires me the way John Mayer obviously does. Like love those guys.
That's it, bro. I'm super excited just to hear you this morning, man. Ça va se passer ici en direct du 102.3 FM Montréal. Merci d'être là, frérot. Puis nous, écoutez, you need to go follow this guy, man. See, mais juste préciser comment tu l'appelles, but you tell me John. Right. I was asking you to
yeah,
John.
Yeah, so I'll explain it. I'll explain you.
Why? Exactly, like the Italian version of like John. Yeah, tell me.
Alors, je m'appelle Jonathan. Puis c'est normal. En Italie, mes amis m'appellent Joe, John. Yeah. Uh-huh. Mais ici à Montréal, tout le monde m'appelle John. Alors pour moi, c'était vraiment important. Je suis italien en fait. Je suis né en Italie, mon père est italien. J'ai fait une année de l'école, de l'université en Italie, à Rome. Alors pour vraiment être italien, je voulais retenir le nom. Puis c'est prononcé John, G-I-O-N. So John, it's not Gian, but you know what? I don't even care.
Just people to find you on Instagram and YouTube everywhere.
Yeah,
and Spotify also.
Yeah, Oh My John. So on Instagram or all social media handles, Oh My John, G-I-O-N. And on Spotify, just check me out, G-I-O-N, John. And
that's it.
You listen to some music.
Some good music.
Yeah.
Some good music.
Thanks.
So Montréal, bougez pas parce que dans quelques minutes, vous aurez une performance exclusive de John ici en direct du 102.3 FM Montréal. Merci d'être là ce matin et n'hésitez pas à vous abonner sur le Warm Up FM.
Découvre en exclusivité tous les artistes d'ici en t'abonnant maintenant à la chaîne du Warm Up.